try to like exercise, but in the like in a couple of days or a few weeks, I completely stop. Cause I know that happens to me frequently. Like I start and then I just stop. So I guess for those people that do that, like me, we might want to consider working out or exercising more longer and being more consistent, because working out or exercising can help out GPA or improve grades. So according to an article called Exercising Linked with Better Grades by Tara Parker, published by the New York Times, she stated that an average college student has a higher GPA due to exercising, and 0.4 is the difference. So, I mean, 0.4 isn't nearly as high, but in college, I think anything helps. And in her research, I believe she studied 20 women. Never mind. So, I guess exercising helps, hasn't helped me like academically, but mostly physically. Because back when, like when I was younger, I had like a health problem with breathing. So that, I couldn't breathe well. So you could say I had like asthma or something. But from exercising, I believe in middle school, because we know got to do bio and over time. So it was part of the grade. So I started running more. And as I started working out more, that started going away, the breathing problem, and now I haven't had it since middle school. So what I'll be talking about in this presentation will be the effects of working out and not working out, or exercising. And of course, the solution. So one of the effects would be obesity. So according to Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, more than one third of the U.S. adults are obese. So that's, if statistically speaking, applies to this classroom, the 30 guys would be, I guess, obese. And I guess that's a pretty high number, because those people are, they're elites to other issues like